Simon & Schuster Audio presents Marriage Triggers, Exchanging Spouses' Angry Reactions for Gentle Biblical Responses by Amber and Guy Lia, read by the authors, with a foreword written by Dave and Ashley Willis and read by Kirby Hayborn.
Marriage Triggers is dedicated to the husbands and wives who are desperate for hope and longing for change. We have prayed over you for many years, and our expectation is that the Holy Spirit will enable you to exchange your angry reactions for gentle biblical responses. May you and your spouse experience every good thing that God prepared for your marriage, and may your hearts be filled with the love of Christ toward one another as you embrace his love for you, his bride.
Foreword. In our family, we love going to the beach, but the beach doesn't seem to love us back. We pay a heavy price to strip down into our swimsuits because we're all prone to getting sunburned. Apparently, Ancestry.com was correct, and our Irish roots run deep on both sides of the family, and for our kids, too. Our pasty white complexion is just part of being in the Willis family, but we don't let that deter us from having some fun in the sun. We pack extra aloe and sunblock, but despite our best efforts, we all know we're going to be driving home with blistered backs and sensitive red skin. Even after a great day of fun and waves, when someone pats us on the back afterward, it evokes a visceral reaction. The seemingly harmless back pat hits such a sensitive area of sunburn that we often overreact with a scream. We've seen our boys push each other and even come close to throwing punches after being touched on their sunburned skin. When we're touched in a place of pain, vulnerability, insecurity, or sensitivity, it can create unintended pain and uncontrolled outbursts. Our family's reaction to sunburns is, in essence, a trigger. A trigger isn't usually as visibly apparent as a sunburn. Triggers are usually hard to see. They're more likely to live within the mind and heart than the skin. Still, these invisible emotional sunburns can trigger powerful and painful responses when left unchecked. In our work with married couples, we've found that most couples are wandering through a minefield of triggers in their marriage. The triggers can be anything from sexual issues to financial issues to in-law stresses to past hurts to a myriad of other factors. Most couples don't have the tools to properly identify these triggers and then develop a proactive game plan to deal with them in a healthy way. We are strongly convinced that properly dealing with triggers is one of the biggest factors that leads to a healthy marriage. This is why we are thrilled that Guy and Amber Lia have written this book on the triggers in your marriage. The book you're about to listen to has the power to transform your marriage and your life if you'll take its lessons to heart. Seriously. I know that probably sounds like we're overselling it, but we're not. Imagine what your marriage could be if you were completely in tune with each other's greatest struggles, needs, desires, and hurts. Imagine how much closer you could be as husband and wife if those topics that cause instant arguments could become the very topics that lead to your most meaningful conversations. Imagine being the safest place on earth for each other. Those are the very things that will happen if you'll apply the lessons you're about to hear in this book. Guy and Amber Lia have given a profound gift to every married couple on earth by writing Marriage Triggers. It's a modern masterpiece of marriage ministry because they had the courage to be so vulnerable and honest in sharing their own story. As the listener, You're about to experience the full spectrum of human emotion through the true stories and timeless biblical truths you're about to hear. You're going to laugh, possibly cry, have new thoughts you've never considered, and have your eyes opened to the depth of intimacy, wholeness, and healing that God desires for your marriage. Take these lessons to heart. Put them into practice. We believe your marriage will be forever transformed as a result. Dave and Ashley Willis, authors of The Naked Marriage and hosts of the Naked Marriage Podcast.
Introduction, Amber. I'm convinced that more marriages are triggered than not. Couples feel angry and frustrated by all the things that set them off. Things like finances, lack of trust, intimacy in the bedroom, personality differences, and busy schedules. Readers often ask me if their anger is justified and how to know the difference. It's an important question for us to examine before we look into these 31 chapters that lie ahead. Author Lou Priolo, in his book, The Heart of Anger, writes this insightful truth about righteous and unrighteous anger. Quote, "If your anger is due to your recognition that a holy God has been offended by another's behavior, that anger is righteous. On the other hand, if your anger is the result of not having your personal desires met, that anger is usually sinful. In other words, if we are angry because someone, without sinning, prevented us from having what we really wanted, our anger is sinful. Of course, it is possible, even probable, in those situations where another person's sin against God is also an offense to us, to have both righteous anger and sinful anger residing in our hearts at the same time." End quote. This really is the idea of hating the sin but loving the sinner, isn't it? We should feel righteous indignation when we see sin and evil in the world or in the lives of our spouses. But what should really get our backs up is that sin is an affront to the God we love, not because it's an affront to us personally. Being impacted by our spouse's sin doesn't give us the right to indulge in our own. Husbands and wives all over the world are waking to a new day, and as soon as it registers mentally that they are awake, the gloom of their strained relationship fills their hearts. We want our marriages to be better, but instead, our triggers often leave us bitter or broken. Many of us go to bed angry, even though we may be familiar with Ephesians chapter 4, verses 26 through 27, ESV. Quote, "Be angry and do not sin. Do not let the sun go down on your anger, and give no opportunity to the devil." End quote. The anger we sometimes feel can be overwhelming. It was for me. When you read chapter 1, you will see what I mean. Everyday triggers are often the culprit. The little things we don't know how to address, or have been addressing wrongly, make us angry and frustrated, with little hope for change. If you have wondered how to break out of the cycle of reactionary outbursts, cold shoulders, resentment, and pain that harms your relationship, you are not alone. There is a better way, and it's not as hard as you think. This book walks you through 31 of the most common marital issues that sabotage great relationships, like poor communication, lack of spiritual leadership, busy schedules, and different parenting styles. The truth is, our unrighteous anger can quickly lead to other sinful attitudes and actions. But it doesn't have to. If you are like me and my husband as we face our own triggers in marriage, each new day brings with it two options. Carry on with the same conflicts and frustrations, reacting angrily and fanning the flames until everyone gets burned. Or learn to practice responding biblically so that love can reign in our hearts, strengthening our own personal walks with God and resulting in a blessed marriage. For many years now, I have been walking through a variety of triggers and gentle biblical responses with parents as they navigate the changing stages and dynamics of parenting. Almost as soon as triggers exchanging parents' angry reactions for gentle biblical responses, was hot off the press, the Holy Spirit planted the seed in my heart to write Marriage Triggers. In my first book in this series, written with my co-author, Wendy Speak, we heard from hundreds of parents who read and reread our book. Often, they expressed this aha moment. Triggers was not helping them fix their kids so they wouldn't have to be angry anymore. Triggers was showing them, trigger by trigger, and verse by Bible verse, that peaceful parenting was not about changing their kids, but about changing their own attitudes and reactions to the triggers in their parenting. The result was a strengthened faith and a radically transformed home. Marriage Triggers is no different. These 31 common triggers in marriage are the result of hundreds of responses and several years of feedback from husbands and wives who feel angry in their relationships. Guy and I spent too many years angry with one another ourselves. We get it. We have learned firsthand and heard from the lips of hundreds of couples that anger doesn't always look like throwing dishes and screaming voices. It can be cold or hot, bitter or sweetly manipulative, withdrawn or aggressive, vengeful or hopeless, careless or clingy, indifferent or idolatrous, loud or quiet, passionate or passive. But every sinful reaction has one thing in common. It's a foothold for all kinds of nastiness, a stepping stone that leads us away from the happy marriage that God desires us to have with one another. As you read, you aren't getting the doctoral treatise from two PhDs who have studied healthy relationships, nor are you getting an intellectual examination of triggers and how to avoid them. You are getting the transparent and practical insights from a couple, a lot like you, who love God and are still learning to love one another well. We are walking right beside you, writing from a place of need for our own marriage, and you'll get a look at differing perspectives. You'll see Amber or Guy next to each chapter title to indicate which of us is addressing each marriage trigger. We anticipate that, like so many men and women, you too may be struggling with your emotions, feeling hopeless, or wondering if things will ever change. God offers all of us this promise. Quote, "And we know that in all things God works for the good of those who love him, who have been called according to his purpose," end quote. Romans chapter 8, verse 28, NIV. Can our triggers work for good? Can our responses lead to a better marriage? Can our anger lead us to a more purposeful relationship? We believe they can, because we believe God. Guy and I encourage you to identify trigger moments as much as you identify the triggers themselves. Having conversations about conflicts late at night when you are tired, in the car where you feel confined, or in the heat of the moment as emotions run rampant, is less than ideal and usually leads to even more anger and frustration. Once you have identified your trigger moments, put a plan in place to regularly come together outside of conflict to lovingly discuss triggers when they arise. Some of our friends have agreements in place with their spouses to never start conversations regarding their marriage triggers during their identified trigger moments. As a result, they are able to talk with one another without anger fueling the conversations, and harmony has been restored in their conflict resolution. When you are faced with a marriage trigger, say something like, "Honey, there's something on my mind that I'd like to talk through with you. Can we set a time on Wednesday to talk about it together?" Sometimes it's hard to delay these conversations, but exercising self-control is a great first step toward being the peacemakers God asks us to be. Let's not waste another moment living angered. The book you are listening to is not a formula full of cut and dried tips and tricks for a happy life, but if you are willing to let the Holy Spirit open your heart to transformation.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.